Mr. Arnold, you can share your screen.
Now you can see?
Everything is clear?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. This presentation is related with this Norway type called storage freezer trawler optimization of ship launching distance between slip bay and the sea. As we know that shipbuilding industry, we have a lot of activities, production, repair, and new building vessel in the shipyard especially. And all these vessels mostly is very huge weight, and some points of the production section need to be the vessels meet to the sea. This has to be done in the some of production stage. And we have a lot of ways to launch the vessel into the sea or water. But most of them, we can say that for the poor item or type of launching ways. One of them is inclining slip bay on slight ways. This is, we can say that as a gravity. These are two different type of launching. The most of them in the launching via this longitudinal launching aft or fore side. And one of them is side launching. Other way to incline use the launching of the vessels using of the airbags. As we know that this was developed by the Chinese people, that they are using this way their launching of the vessel. And third of the way, the float out with a vessel in dry or floating dock. There is no any actually launching process. This is just for the water fill in the dry dock, or just using the floating dock with the classical docking process. Fourth one is using horizontal plane by land transfer with new transportation system called SPMT, self-propelled modular transportation. This is for kind of parallel movement of the vessels from land into the water, into the sea. We can see that we will talking about in this presentation the longitudinal launching with the slight ways. And we are now see that the typical section of the arrangement of the sliders and slip bay and the vessel itself at the same picture. In this picture, we saw that slip bay has capable to carry the vessel which we designed or which we built to intact the vessel in the shipyard. Means that especially to the weight has to be no known before the construct the slipway, design the slipway, and also we have seen that now here the upper slider. This is connected to the vessel itself, connection with the rope and some steel rope. Another part of the sliders is lower slider. It is fixed. It is connected to the slipway. Such a fixed ways to need to implement the sliders into the onto the slipway. In this picture, we saw that also the oils between the sliders that is need to be for this sliding process. This is typical view for that we are using in the our shipyard for the launching. We saw that our one of vessel before we built to the Canadian owner, but it is a Norwegian type of preserved trawler. And we saw that sliders and cradles on the forest side. These are need to be implemented on the vessel before the launching. And the other sliders to the from forest side to the outside, below the bottom of the vessel. Actually, between sliders, between slipways and bottom of the vessel itself. Here is the some explanation about the inclination ratio of the slipways. We can say that for the small ship, we have inclination approximately 6.5. For a medium size, 6.5, between 6.5 for 5. And for a large ships, 5 to 4 inclination as a percentage that we need to build the slipway. The longitudinal launching, they have advantages for this is the low operational cost. Use a simple equipment and means that less time for preparation for the launching. Use for ships for of different tonnage and type. And this is oldest way and well known operation that we need to not a question mark before the operation. But it is also has this disadvantage. One of them is high initial investment cost because especially this high initial investment cost because of the slipway prices, the investment cost, because need to allow to carry the huge weight of the vessels and need to be enough strength of the slipway. And there is some high operational risks we can face. And this is coming because of when the vessel start to the movement, the movement is not under control of any external parties. Means that they have just under control via the gravity. And if you do not calculation before start of the movement, and this will be cause some problem, and we don't want to face that. And limited vessel, this way because of mostly we can launch the vessel with this way as the conventional type of vessel. We see that here the sliders and the forces and the length. Here we saw that connection point with the sea of the slipway below this connection point at the sea means that there is wet, we can call like wet slipway, wet slides, slider length and bay, and upper side dry, we can call dry slideway. Now we saw that distribution of the loads, some of one of our previous vessels, that is just for the one slider. We saw that the forces and this vessel have been two sliders, slideways in the launching. We have some calculation and stage in the launching process. All the things, all these calculations have been done before the vessel, the launch. That's why it is very important case to the calculation. The launch weight is defined as the sum of the weight of the ship and the weights of the moving elements like slipways using in the launching. This means that this will be our total weight for the launching, and this weight will be using in the calculation. And launching stage, we can say that for passes, and there are a lot of force and a lot of force we will face all this stage, stage by stage. First period is starting of the initial movement to the first contact of the sliders with the water. There is only one forces we have. The movement of the vessel itself and the gravity, the weight of the vessel to the slipway, to the sliders. Second stage, this is the wet period on the sliders in the water, and the movement from the first contact of the sliders with the water or sea, and start to start rotating in the forward cradle. These are means that actually we have buoyancy forces and weights of the vessel in this stage, and in this stage weight of vessel higher than this buoyancy force, and it means that the vessel is not turning or rotating in this stage. The third period is starting the rotation around the forward cradle. In this stage means that we have the vessel have the buoyancy force, and this is bigger than the weight of the vessel itself. And in this stage, vessel start to turning around the cradle. This rotating is depend on the difference of the momentum, the moment of the buoyancy and weight of vessel forces. the last period, the fourth period, is free floating period. It means that there is no any more contact to the slipway of the vessel, and vessel have the just free floating, and it is just need to wait the vessel stop. And in this case, the buoyancy force equal to the weight of the vessel. This is the floating condition. In this launching calculation, we have some cases. I'm talking about to just the major things, because maybe there are minor things and the minor cases also happen, but the most important case in this launching, the tipping and rotation around the forces, around for a cradle. Actually, we don't want to face and we don't want to see that this tipping in the launching, but it is not possible. Seems that possible, but it have to be using some way to not face the tipping. That's why we have to be put some additional ways to avoid the tipping. Rotating around the cradle, this is we talked in the stage. In this case, we saw that the buoyancy moment from the threshold minus the weight of the vessel, the threshold is the moment, is higher than the zero, means that buoyancy moment is higher. In this case, the vessel rotating in the for a cradle, that means that the for a cradle is facing with the some forces. It has to be also to consider and calculate before the sea trial in the calculation stage, and to find to be sure that the cradle itself strength is sufficient for this phase, for these forces in the launching process. All these things, all these cases has to be calculated before the calculation, before the launching of the vessel. And in this article and the presentation, we want to present to the length of the wet slipway, what have to be as a ideally. Actually, this is mostly depend on a lot of parameters in the launching calculation that we are seeing. That's why what is change, what can be changed, what the items not can be cannot be changed. That's why this is important to know or to select the which vessel will be built in the with the slipway and the wet slipway length. We try to
Mr. Ani, could you please speed up?
Okay. We saw that in this table, seven vessels, and the first row of the realized one, the second row is the ideal position, ideal calculation. And in this case, we saw that with this different type of vessel, with this LOA, need to be as a ideally between 75 meters, 120 meters wet sliders, slip bay in the water, in the sea. These are now presented with our vessels we have inspected in this presentation and in this article. These will be changed, of course, change which vessel you will consider into with this calculation, and this will be need to be considered accordingly. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for your detailed presentation, Mr. Anik. We can You're take welcome. Questions, if any.
I have a question to Mr. Arnak. Of course, there are many computations in his presentation. I think in the conclusion part, the first paragraph is interesting. From 60 to 108 meters, you have a series of launching calculations ready for applying other coming vessels, I think. This kind of vessels you get always.
Order.
Yeah, order. when you get the orders of these vessels, you face with the problems, then you approach with the calculations, with the research and development. This is good. Results show that ideal wet slideway length is between 75 to 120 meters. This is also interesting. Congress is an occasion for you to share this effort, this research with other colleagues, with other industry members. So it is a good contribution. I congratulate you and your company.
Thank you so much. That what we have aimed at to prepare this article and this presentation to show the people who is interested in this kind of calculation and this kind of investment, maybe to see the what will face what will, they will face. Because this type of vessel is some special vessels, and this is not easy to find to some information.
Yeah.
And I believe that this will be help to who wants to need to reach. And thank you so much.
Thank you so much. But your first page of the presentation, I have seen only two names, two authors. But in your full paper text, there was Mr. Görkem, Mr. Görkem Kampara. Haven't you changed the order of the authors and then authors? Have you changed something or not? If yes, we should change it in the full text. As well.
I think yes, he is the one of the person that to help to prepare this article and the presentation. That's why he, I think he has to be in in this article.
As in the full text. All right, no problem. Yeah.
Okay.
As it is. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Excellent. And this session. Is over, I guess, and I want to hand over the floor to Professor Okan.
Yeah, thank you very much. Our session starts with number 44, presentation 44, Yusuf Genç et alias, at 6 o'clock Turkish time. So until 6 o'clock, let's have a break. It is hot. We are in Tuzla now. It is hot, so...
as well.
7-8 minutes of thank you very much, dear Chairman, Professor Özkök, and Professor Demirel. Thank you very much. And the authors and audiences, thank you.
You are welcome.
After 7 minutes, we will be here.
Okay.